So I'm here with Joe from HaptX and Andrew from our Seattle office, who's trying out the HaptX system. Do you want to tell us about it, Joe?
Yeah, I'd love to. So what Andrew's trying out here right now is HaptX Gloves. Mm-hmm. It is the first product that HaptX is working on. This current generation is a development kit generation. We only have a handful of these systems right now. It effectively enables users that currently use VR for design and training to be able to touch and interact and feel the virtual world that they're touching and interacting with.
So at the moment, Andy can actually feel what he's holding there in the screen. So he's picked up a cloud and he's got his hand underneath and he can feel the rain on his fingers.
Precisely. So there's an array of bubbles in the palm and the fingertips, and we inflate those bubbles at the right pressure based upon the interactions happening in the game engine. So we measure the forces and we can deflect the skin the appropriate amount as if you're actually really grabbing those objects.
And now I've had a go at this and it's incredibly realistic. It's quite hard to describe. What side of the project have we worked on at Synapse?
So as most people know, I hate saying this, but hardware is a hard thing to do right. Synapse has really helped our small design team, which did a great job at making this proof of concept, turn that into something that we can actually manufacture at scale. The hardest technical challenge has definitely been manufacturing our tactile laminate layer. We use a lot of processes from microfabrication, but at a larger scale. And not everybody wants to make the molds with that small of features, but with such a large part size. So working with Synapse to try to find the right vendors and manufacturers and kind of improve the design so that people will accept those and build those for us at volume, so we're not just doing it in a garage in San Luis Obispo.
Great, okay, thanks very much, Jake.